When you think of a Lexus, you think of affordable luxury. What you don't think of, though, is this model, which is the LS400, which is actually Lexus's first model car that they ever made.
Is it?
So, we're here in the Peak District with Nervous Neil and his lovely Lexus. Talk us through your Lexus.
Well, I've only owned it 4 weeks.
4 weeks.
And ever since I've had it, that's it. It's definitely a keeper.
Yeah, fallen in love with it straight away. It's all about the boxy cars, isn't it, you fall in love with. What have you done with it in that sort of short space of time?
Up to now, when I bought it, the cats were leaking. So, fixed them, made it sound a bit better. Not had time to do anything with it, really, as of yet.
How was the condition of it when you got it?
It was okay, it needed a good old wash.
Yeah? You say you got a pretty good deal out of it?
Yeah, for what they're worth, I didn't pay that much for it, considering what the market price is at the moment for them.
Should always go after old people with their cars like this. Always go after old people. Hunt them down.
Obviously, this car, on the camera, does look clean, but on closer inspection, let's have a look at some of these dents and scrapes.
Yeah. Scrape there. Not the best wheels on it.
No.
Yeah, even more on the wheels.
Then back bumper.
Oh, the rear bumper's taking some hits. The rear bumper is really taking some damage.
That corner one was done a couple of days before I bought it in Blackpool. It's that big in the car parking space. People just clip them.
So what's caused all these? Just
the only thing I can think is the old boy putting his golf clubs in and out of the boot.
Oh, that's not
catching them.
What happened here, mate?
I really couldn't tell you.
What is that? Is that filler?
I don't know if it is bog.
That's definitely filler. Filler with a bit of spray.
Just needs some love. But underneath of it's solid. Engine's bone dry.
Look at that. That's just medicine, isn't it?
Cool. Proper JDM.
It's proper JDM.
A bit dirty under there, but for an old car it's not too bad.
Is this is the reason why you bought this car?
Correct.
What is it?
It's a 1UZ, 4-litre V8, absolutely bulletproof.
Yep.
Torquey and powerful for what they are. They drink a lot of fuel, but they're just so reliable. It's like this, look how clean the oil is. Can hardly see on the dipstick it's that clean. It's literally, it's the service history of it. It's got an absolutely huge booklet with it.
So why did you want a V8?
Just the noise, really.
Just the noise.
Mainly.
The noise and the grunt. So there's a slight breeze, isn't there, Neil? If you let go.
Magic. There you go.
God.
Didn't fit that standard, did they?
Hey, I'm going to turn into.
It's nice and
comfy. Sure, yes. Oh, right on the bump.
Seems to be taking these up inclines quite easily, doesn't it?
It's got the power.
How much power does it have?
I think last time I looked up it was about 250 to 270-ish.
Nothing wrong with that. Nice little bit of power.
It just costs money when you put your foot down.
Does it really drink, does it?
Yeah. It prefers longer journeys. Short little bursts are no good for it.
Like motorway miles and stuff?
Yeah.
They're just sat at the same...
I think that's what they were built for, really, weren't they?
Hi, Sarah.
That's a good thing with old cars, though, isn't it? They're just so cool.
So is that why you get into your old cars, is it? Because it's just easier to work on, something you can actually get your hands into?
As well, I just prefer them anyways. What I've been brought up with, what I know. Whereas all the new modern cars, they're nice, don't get me wrong, but for what you pay for them, it's like this. When these were brand new, what, 30, 40 grand?
Mm.
94, it's a lot of money. Now you can pick them up for, depending on the condition, a grand upwards.
Yeah. And it is a nice car. It's lovely. It's really looked after.
Well, that's the thing. I think he's been an old boy for bloody 20 years.
Oh, is it?
And he's spent endless money on it. The service history is like, this is your life. Apparently, I had the Campbell water pump service every 5,000 miles.
Mm. There's not much to say about it other than it's just really clean and really nice. It's just nice. It's like you get into cars and they're like some of the cars I've gotten into recently, they're all like loud and ridiculous. And this is just a nice, it's just nice.
Well, that's the thing, it's comfortable.
Yeah.
I've done me years of having King rock boxes, thrash and drift cars, toy cars, and I've always wanted one of these. And the engines, from what I understand, they're pretty much bulletproof.
Mm. Well, everything
else around it that breaks, like the ECU and stuff. They weren't very good at the electronics, but the engines, they knew what they were doing.
Yeah. Well, I mean, very common engine. I mean, it's uncommon to find one in the car that it originally came in. Everyone's taken them out.
Correct. A lot of the drift lads like them, don't they? Because of the torque and the power out of them.
Mm. Later on in life, this is kind of what you want, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, I am later on in life now. This is my granddad car.
Yeah. So what is it with Lexus and blue interior? Well, what is it with like blue leather
and coloured interiors?
Yeah.
I don't know. I wanted the one with the black interior, but I couldn't be that picky. One came up with the colour of the outside, the colour I wanted.
Yeah.
I weren't too fussed about the interior. That can change that over time.
It's very JDM colour, that outside, isn't it?
Yes.
And is the inside JDM? Inside JDM colour?
No. I'd say it looks JDM, but the colour is... The walnut just doesn't... just retro in general, it's not cool. Not in my taste anyway.
You've got a picture what they were thinking, like in the design rooms and stuff like that. It's like, what colour should we have the interior? We'll have it
some horrible
wizard cloak blue. it's wizard cloak blue, isn't it? Oh, look at that panoramic sunroof.
That works.
And it works,
everything works, even the aircon until it breaks. Shouldn't have said that, really. Something's going to go on me today, isn't it?
Nah.
It's been a week and it's not gone on me.
These cars will never ever break down. That was the episode with the Lexus and Neil and Sarah in the background. Neil's a good mate of mine and he's nervous on camera. So we could forgive him a little bit, because he's been kind enough to show you around his Lexus, which is really nice. If you like this video, like it, share it, and you know, subscribe if you want to see more like this. Not like this, because not because it's you know.
No.
But yeah. Cheers, Neil. Thank you very much.
Safe.
Dab.
Thank you.
Yeah. That's it.
My bad.
Cheers for ruining my shot. It's an absolutely gorgeous scenery countryside in the Peak District with Neil. Neil, you've got a Lexus. Right. Ah, that was crap.
Yes.